myself Umesh Shantaram Patil. I am present working at in Jalgao district at Jawahar High School Girad. This video is for the presentation of the program QIME, Quality Improvement in Maths Education Program, which is run by RMSA and IIT Bombay. In this program, we have provided training, and this is the part of training to make a video, because in this training the groups are made and a particular group has given a topic, and my topic is K method. K method included in ratio and proportion. Some outlines are given by respected Rana sir. According to these outlines, this video is to be made in three steps. These are the three steps: observe and explore. Second step is define and prove. And third one is apply and evaluate. As per these three steps, I have to make a video. So I take first step, observe and explore. In this step, I give you some examples.
One student get one dress. Five student get five dress.
See here, this is the first example. For one student, one dress, and for five students, get five dresses. So if I find a ratio of student to dress, then I will get 1/1 and 5/5. Means in simplest form, this is the ratio 1. So both ratios 1/1 and 5/5. Both are equal ratios. In this way, we give another examples, and we find that there are many examples in our daily life. They are called as a equal ratio. For make it more clear, I will give you second example. If one cup ice cream cost ₹420. 4 cup ice cream cost ₹80. If I find a ratio number of cup to its cost, that is 1/20. Similarly, 4/80. If I make them ratio in simplest form, I will get 1/20. So again, here both ratios are same. So what we observed here, that the examples are of equal ratio. Means after doing simplification, we get the same numerical value. Let that numerical value be any letter or anything, but both ratio or number of ratio, they have a same value. Let the same value be K. So in this way, we have to find K method. So as per this method, we can find number of ratio, or if any one term of the ratio is missing, we will find that term by using the concept K method. Okay, now we will turn to our second step, define and prove. What is the K method? K method is a method in which all the ratios have same numerical value, and that value is constant. If the ratios are equal and they have a constant simplest form, these ratios are called equal ratios, and we suppose them as a same numerical value. That value may be k. For proving this definition, I will give you some examples. For example, 5 upon 10 and 10 upon 20. So 5 upon 10 is equal to what? 1 upon 2. And 10 upon 20 is equal to what? 1 upon 2. Therefore, 5 upon 10 is equal to 10 upon 20. Second example, 8 upon 9. 8 upon 9 and 32 upon 36. So after doing simplification, I will get 8 upon 9. Therefore, 8 upon 9 is equal to 32 upon 36. Hence, it is proved that the equal ratios have a same numerical value, same simplest form. Now we will turn to our third step. The last step of this video is third step, apply and evaluate. In this step, I will give you some examples in which this concept is to be used. For example, x upon 5 is equal to y upon 7 is equal to 1 upon 2. See here, x upon 5 and y upon 7 both are same ratios and their numerical value is 1 by 2. Hence, the constant is 1 by 2. Let it be k. X by 5 is equal to k and y by 7 is equal to k. X by 5 is equal to 1 upon 2 and y by 7 is equal to 1 upon 2. So, making two separate equations, we can find out the value of x. X is equal to 5 by 2 and y is equal to 7 by 2. Therefore, x is equal to 2.5 and y is equal to 3.5. So, the help of k method, we can find the missing terms x and y in both the ratios. Similarly, we will find another missing terms which are not given in the equal ratios. I will give you another example, second example. I have taken second example and I have written it on board. See, what is the example? A certain recipe calls for 3 kilograms of sugar for every 6 kilograms of flour. If 60 kilograms of sweet has to be prepared, how much sugar is required? In this example, we have to find how much sugar is required. So by using the K method of equal ratio, we can easily find this answer. Let it be X. We don't know how much sugar is required, and that amount of sugar I have supposed is X kilograms. So, what is ratio here? Weight of sugar upon weight of flour. See, in the first sentence, a certain recipe calls for 3 kilograms of sugar for every 6 kilograms of flour. So, from the first sentence, the ratio is 3 upon 6, and in the second sentence we will get the ratio x upon 60. So both ratios are same. K method, both ratios have a same numerical value. So by doing cross multiplication, we will get the value of x. 3 into 60 is equal to x into 6. 3 into 60 upon 6 is equal to x. 2 1 the 2, 2 3 the 6 and 0. Therefore, x is equal to what? 30. So, for making the 60 kilograms of sweet, we need 30 kilograms of sugar. Now, one more example I will give you to clear it more. Is equal to y upon b is equal to z upon c. Show that x cube upon a cube plus y cube upon b cube plus z cube upon c cube is equal to 3xyz upon a, b, c. Means this is the given part. These three ratios are equal and we have to prove this. So, see the answer. Here three ratios are equal. See, these three ratios are equal and this is the given part. Means each ratio have a same numerical value. That value is, I suppose, k. So, every ratio has a same value and that is k. If I write these ratios like this, then I will get the values of x in terms of k. X is equal to ak, y is equal to bk and z is equal to ck. Now I have to show this equal to this, means this side is equal to that side. So first we will solve LHS. So what is LHS? X cube upon a cube plus y cube upon b cube plus z cube upon c cube. Now I am putting the values of x, y, z here. So what is x here? Ak. But here it is x cube. So a cube k cube upon a cube, b cube k cube upon b cube, and last one c cube and k cube divided by c cube. So a cube gets cancelled, b cube gets cancelled, c cube gets cancelled. So here is k cube plus k cube plus k cube. That is 3k cube. This is the value of LHS. Now what I have to do? I have to solve RHS. And if after solving the RHS, if I get 3k cube, then and then we say that LHS is equal to RHS. Hence it will be proved. Now try to solve RHS. 3xyz upon ABC. Again put the values of x, y and z here. So ak into bk into ck upon abc. aa gets cancelled, bb gets cancelled, cc cancelled. So the answer is 3k cube. So we can easily say that LHS is equal to RHS, and hence by using this concept we can make, so we can say from this example that number of examples covering the K method can easily be solved. And again I would like to say thanks to our respected Rana sir. Because of this program I had get a chance to make this video. Thank you.